end. Like, none of what happened happened. This is a clean slate. We have a nice little match between NYU Talon and NYU Potato going on. We drafted, started the game, said Juani didn't have Smite. She had Ignite.
Yep.
So we had a very Papega game. Somehow it took, like, 10 minutes of that game to convince the teams that we should remake when the jungler didn't have Smite. But we did. We're currently in the observer delay waiting for that to start.
I believe the teams are going to be the same, although I do believe that Sejuani is going to have Smite this time. If Sejuani does not have Smite this time,
we're going to go for a walk or something.
we're going to hand in our resignation.
Yeah, that's going
to
be enough.
Can you resign from something that you volunteer to do and also don't get paid for?
I don't see why not.
Okay, team comps are the same. Sejuani, Smite. Lilia also has Smite. Okay, cool. I think we're going to have a game here.
We did it. Okay, cool. So over on the blue side, we have NYU Talon. Over on the red side, we have NYU Potato. In the top lane, we have Fiora. In the jungle, we have Lilia. In the mid lane, we have Aatrox. Down in the bot lane, we have a Thresh and a Yasuo. For Potato on the red side, we have a Set, a Sejuani, a Fizz, an Ezreal, and a Swain.
Yep. Just note for people watching is that the champion icons on the sides didn't end up getting lined up this time, so they're not in the roles. Like, they're not aligned in the roles necessarily, and that's okay. We're going to live with that.
We'll be fine.
Yeah, so it looks like they're just going to hang out here in their jungle. Lilia's looking, if you look at the minimap, Lilia is looking towards the red of the enemy team. So I think they're going to, I don't think they're going to end up knowing. Oh, here comes Set, actually.
So at level one, I don't know who's favored here. It is a 2v1, so he's going to need to pop this plant ASAP. Looks like he's not going to be able to get it. And if he pops the plant now, the Lilia is going to be with him, but he just walks casually back into the base. He's a top laner, so he's going to be able to recall and make it to lane on time. Hopefully.
Might have to burn the teleport here.
I hope he doesn't. That's not a summer spell you want to burn this early. Okay, finally. Okay, well, looks like we're going to have a fairly normal start. Sejuani will be getting her blue buff
and the XP from it. Okay, so someone in chat also, at our production guys, if you, I think drag and drop maybe on the scoreboard, on the observer side, it might end up fixing it on the side, so maybe we could give that a shot. Also, Lilia's going to start on the enemy side, is going to pick up the red buff there. So we'll see if Sejuani knows about this and goes for the red. One thing we saw in that partial game is that Sayaren on this Aatrox is kind of a menace.
Yeah.
So we will see. It looks like that does work. Thank you to a wild Terry in chat. We appreciate you.
Shout out to homie.
Yeah, so this Aatrox was a menace in that partial game we saw. We'll see if that continues.
And we talked about this in the delay last time. This is a really bad matchup for Fizz in the mid lane.
Yeah, this is really hard for Fizz. It's gonna be really rough. So cool. So Aatrox is going to farm up. As we can see, Fizz already struggling a little bit. What can you tell me about Fizz farming under a turret early? Is that as rough as it looks?
Not great. Okay, good hook here that turns into an ignite, but it looks like he might be able to make it out. No, the Yasuo with the follow-up and picks up the first bullet. Still staying on to the Ezreal here. He should have Tornado in just a moment. But blows the flash just in time to avoid the flame. But Sejuani is here trying to pick up the kill on to the Yasuo.
No songs on blue side.
But for a second here, it looked like they were trying to turn it. It seems like they still are. The Sejuani is forced to flash, and the Tornado misses. Looks like the Talon might try and just disengage. Bob the Snail gets to walk away with his life, albeit no summoner spells. Over in the mid lane, we have a nearly dead Fizz, albeit with summoner spells.
Yep, that was really close. Thresh almost going down. Good gank timing there from the Sejuani to almost try and salvage something, but it is going to be a 1-0 for the Yasuo. As we see some damage coming out from this Ezreal. Ezreal is now out of mana. Oh, here comes the root, though. Oh, wow.
And really, really good pick there from the side of Potato.
Yes, that's I like ducks on the Swain. Really good job getting that pick. 1-1 now. It's going to go over to the Swain, which is maybe not ideal. But Yasuo is dead. Big wave crashing. And that's a big pickup on the way of NYU Potato.
Up in the top lane, we have a fight here. But the Fiora, for a moment, did have the XP lead. And over in the mid lane, this Fizz has very little HP, and again, last time we had another really good flash knockup play. We had another one this time, but went under tower with a little too little health. Both of them will pick up a kill, and it looks like the Aatrox is going to return to lane with just a second Doran's Blade.
Actually a third Doran's Blade also. Excuse me.
What
three?
A...
I can't say I support that. I have feelings about picking up multiple Doran's Blades these days.
You're a Doran's
Especially hater. Since you want to be building a Caulfield's Warhammer on Aatrox anyway, so I think picking up double Longsword here is way better. But you know what? I'm not Diamond 2. So we're gonna see how Saren works. He now has 10% lifesteal, actually 9% lifesteal, which is kind of a lot.
Yep.
And here he goes onto the Fizz again already. Here comes the Chain.
The Chain does manage to trigger before the Fizz can walk away, and it was a big, big minion wave there, so even though he was under the tower, he really did not want to fight.
Yep, and no more Qs from the Aatrox is the only reason he can follow up. Here comes Sejuani. Fizz is really low.
Misses the second part of the Q, hits the third.
Oh my gosh.
But this Sejuani is very, very, very weak compared to the Aatrox. This could be dangerous. The Fizz tries to return some damage there. The Q should be coming off the cooldown in just a moment. And the Fizz decides to flash the Lilia thing.
Bubble?
Bubble?
We're going to call it a
ball.
We're going to call it a bubble.
Bowling ball.
Bowling ball. The Lilia bowling ball. Yeah, that's an interesting choice. No six for the... Did you see that animation there? The Fizz E'd, but the timing somehow wasn't right to avoid the part of the chain, so he got pulled out of it.
The Fizz made the mistake of reactivating the E. The thing about Playful Trickster is that
you have to sit in it for a minute to get the full benefit of that unparticle
there. You don't want to reactivate it, like, most of the time. Over in the top lane, we see the Vital get procced. This set has a ton of rage built up here. When is he going to be able to blow it? He decides to be incredibly patient. The Sejuani misses her E.
Flash here.
Set decides to flash over, but he's really, really low
HP.
Oh,
six for Fiora.
The Fiora manages to pop six, but it's not enough. Full Machine getting the kill up in the top lane. Had to blow the flash, but this is still very, very worth it. Down on farm and might be able to recoup some of this. Possibly, if we can take a look at the top lane here for just a moment, he might be able to set up a freeze if I looked at the lane.
Yeah, is this freezable? Where is the
wave?
It is
definitely freezable, but we'll see if he does. It's gonna be, I'm not sure he has the clear to clear all of these minions without taking a ton of damage.
And Lilia is here top to actually make sure that it does, in fact, crash. Good awareness from the Lilia is going to be a teleport from the Fiora. And Seth's going to have to back off. Does have the teleport, get back to lane. So he's just going to reset here, come back to lane with that kill under his belt. And we going to take a breath from the top lane. One thing I'd like to point out is there's a 10 farm lead in the jungle, although there is an assist on the side of Sejuani. There's also a 46 to 18 gap in the mid lane. Bot lane is
which we saw in the scuff game before this, and it wasn't surprising. This is a very, 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 very tough lane for Fizz. It's very, very hard to farm. You basically just can't trade ever. You also can't fight. You can't really do any assassinating. And down in the bot lane, you're going to have a tough time getting onto the bot lane for roams. Same with the top side. This is just a rough game to beat Fizz. Manages to hit a Q. Pops it into the play, and it looks like the Yasuo is trying to get onto this Ezreal. Good dodges here. The tornado lands, and that will be a dead Ezreal. But once again, it looks like this Ignite is ticking. Manages to return it, but the Yasuo should be able to finish up this Swain. 2-for-1 to the side of Talon, and that is a scary, scary Yasuo. The Sejuani has arrived, but I don't know if Sej wants to get involved on this.
Yeah, I think Sejuani's just going to back off. So we talked about this a little bit in the first pregame, I guess, which is that one of the reasons I think Yasuo is not great into this Ezreal Swain lane is it's really hard to get onto the champions. They're very good at disengaging. That being said, if you do manage to do it, you do a lot of damage. So that's an example of a great fresh hook there. No ability to escape from the Ezreal, and Yasuo picking up that double kill. Swain now looking mid.
This is not going to go the way that he wants. He's down 2 levels and a bunch of items.
Yep, a lot of damage going over.
The Facebreaker misses here. So for just a moment, the Vital's in the wrong place. I don't think he's going to turn. This starts with the Flay. We don't see what's going on. Looks like a Vital got
I think Sejuani is going to get away, bot. Did have to burn the flash, it looks like. Yep, Sejuani is going to be all right. But they're just going to hang out here now in the enemy jungle. Maybe look to start up this dragon here in just a second.
We'll see. The bubble does pop. Lilia is 6. Could go for the sleep here.
Decides
to do it. And now the Thresh is in range. And this is just a play into an ult, into a hook. And this is real, real bad news from side of Potato.
Swain flashes away.
The Yasuo decides to follow up. Gets a good kill onto the Swain. And despite taking a tower shot, is just A-OK. Oh no. The wind wall manages to block the
great
wind wall
to block the snail.
And again, looks like there's really, really good follow-up. But oh my god, the Lilia is dead off of a great kill on the side of Ezreal.
Blinded here on this Ezreal is 1v3 isn't gonna get away from this one, I don't think.
And the Yasuo decides to follow.
Whoa, wow. Sayarin. Sayarin on this Aatrox, man.
This is scary.
Nasty. Alright, Fizz is back. Here comes the Chumble Water. Chumble Water does come through on the fresh. Miles? I think he realizes he's dead.
Yeah, it doesn't look like Playful Trickster was up in time. So we have a nice ARAM here in the jungle, and Sayarin is once again off of the opportunity to completely style on Potato here.
Unstoppable for Bob the Snail. And that is going to be, at the end of the day, a 6 for 2? I don't even know anymore. I lost count.
Well, it's
6-1 on Yasuo.
It's a 3,500 farm lead over to the side of Talon.
That would be a lot of farm.
I did say farm.
That would
gold
be,
lead.
That would be a significant farm lead. Yes, 3,500 gold lead on the side
but
of
it's,
NYU
it's very
Talon.
Important that we notice where these kills are. These kills are exactly where you want them.
On the Yasuo, a couple kills on this Aatrox. Facebreaker does come in here. Here comes the set.
Manages to pop it down, but these vitals are in a really good spot. Manages to pop the ult, and with one more hit here, he would have popped the ult, but he does pop the ult. By the time he pops the ult, he manages to pick up the health regen.
Oh, great hook.
Phenomenal hook lands, and after one kill is picked up for the side of Talon, they decide to go deep here. The Fresh manages to hold the aggro perfectly and walks out with his life.
Wow. Yeah, this Yasuo is really strong. Has probably actually a lot of gold sitting on now too. 90-30 in the mid lane. He's got 2,600 gold in his pocket at the moment. 6,000 gold total, almost 3,000 bucks. Ezreal, mid lane, we're looking at another 2,000 gold lead. So the carries here on the side of NYU Talon are really starting to run up the numbers. So 20 is just going to almost die just trying to hold mid lane. Dragon is also going to go over to the side of blue side. So complete control right now for Talon. Really methodical. These carries are popping off. The one lane they're losing is top. That's how top island goes when the jungler spends their entire game bot lane. But other than that, really solid looking for NYU Talon at the moment.
Well, it is unfortunate that Fiora isn't going to be online for a long time, if ever, but the truth is, this Yasuo down in bottom lane will just be able to do whatever he wants.
Jesus,
over
Sayarin.
In the mid lane, Sayarin doing his absolute best to get this kill. The Chumba Waters gets popped by Miles, and he just has to stand and watch his tower get absolutely wailed. And oh my god, the perfect edge gets landed by Sayarin, and that's another kill, and this Fizz is a non-factor.
He's
30 farm in 12 minutes.
He's so nasty on this Aatrox, man. Just perfectly knows how the champion is operating.
Over in the top lane, though, Chrysalith taking a lot of damage. The Vitals is on the wrong side.
Oh!
We have a bit of a weird... Oh my god.
And here comes the grand challenge. No W, no... Oh my god, Chrysalith. Right. So he riposts the ult there from the set. Does manage to get it off. That means that the stun comes through, doesn't get any of that damage, and then flash is the W, the punch.
Well, over in the mid lane, Tomato's just absolutely dead. Sayarin is a monster on this Aatrox.
Yeah. Anyway, though, great play from the Fiora. Just totally outplayed him in the top lane. Really well done, and is going to get a couple of platings for his trouble. Meanwhile, the bot lane, Ezreal's going to try and farm up here, but as whatever Yasuo is in lane, it's pretty difficult. 7-1 has Phantom Dancer completed here.
And a 7k gold lead over to the side of Talon.
Yeah, wow. That's a lot of gold.
Bob the Snail is a monster.
Yep. Yeah.
I actually think he probably wins a 2v1. And looks like we'll get to see. Gets to go in. The world that, or the ult gets popped.
Oh, wow.
But, oh my god, he's taking so much damage. Can he lifesteal it up here? He tries. Manages to get out of the bush, but
shut
doesn't have
down.
Vision for just a moment there, and gets shut down by the Ezreal.
I believe that was a max or nearly max shutdown. I'm not sure if it was 900.
It was 900.
900.
Yeah.
Okay, so nearly max shutdown over to the Ezreal. That is big. That's a lot of gold back over.
But this Lilia is caught here. I don't know if the set decides to path a little bit in the wrong direction, but doesn't manage to fix his mistake.
Neither
here.
Top has ult here.
Well, it looks like. Oh my god, this set is taking a ton of damage. Fiora manages to follow up, but doesn't quite get the kill. This set manages to heal up enough to not die, and that's two kills over to the Sejuani.
Hesh Tomato here, showing the power of remembering to take Smite on a jungler and having actual XP. No, all kidding aside, really well played from the Sejuani there. And Sayarin here is just going to pressure the hell out of everything he can.
The hook just barely misses, but Sayarin's doesn't. The flash gets blown by someone. I guess not. The Aatrox here is so, so strong. Let's see if he can hold on for just long enough to be able to turn this. But he's sitting in a 3v1 now. He's rooted. He's stunned. I don't know if he's going to be able to do anything. The CC gets chained and chained and chained. Oh. But Sayarin is somehow still not dead.
Oh, my God. Chain comes through here. Is going to start trying to kill this Sejuani now. They're all so low. And here comes Fiora. And suddenly, this is now a 2v2 that they have the advantage in. Unbelievable that he doesn't die there.
Chrysalith manages to pick up the kill there, and now this Fizz just has to run for his life.
Yep, Set's going to try and help, but doesn't know exactly where they are. Is going to contest this Fiora. Has the ultimate, but he's just going to get chunked down again, and Sayarin now...
Sayarin has flash!
Has the position. Is... Oh!
Gets knocked under tower and takes so much damage here. Doesn't manage to actually get the Q off, and Fiora trades Grand Challenge in her life for a kill onto the Fizz.
Is going to be a double kill over for the Fizz. Fizz now 4 and 5, and here we see an ult. Isn't quite flash away from the Sejuani. Bob the Snail doesn't quite have the burst quite yet. That is a little bit of tankiness on the Sejuani. He will soon. Cinderbolt completed for the Sejuani, so that Hatch Tomato won't fall immediately. Hook onto the Swain now, and here comes the box. Ult. We'll keep him alive. Oh my gosh, I like Ducks. Does get the kill over onto Bob the Snail. So, another kill over to the side of NYU Potato. That gold lead has been cut down now to about five gold lead. No,
five gold lead. Hold on. There's a Mage Eyes over on the side of Sayarin right now.
Wow. Does that item do any?
I don't know. Okay, well, it looks like the hook lands here, but I guess Thresh just wanted to disengage for a moment there. It looks like Lilia felt differently, but the Aatrox decided to put some pressure in here, secure this blue buff over for the Lilia. Dragon has just spawned, and I imagine they'll be turning their attention to it here in just a moment. Just taking every single camp over in Potato's jungle, but they just decided to get the engage, but a very, very good stopwatch off of the side of the Swain here. Keeps him alive for just a moment. Sayarin here locked in a 1v3. He goes down. There's just too many members of Potato, and overall, it ends up being a 2v1 over their side. This is a Thresh versus Ezreal matchup, and the Thresh doesn't have any cooldowns. He has to wait here.
Oh, the Windwall!
The Windwall does appear.
Good flash,
the Playful Trickster lands, dealing a ton of damage and finishing off the Thresh. It's Bob the Snail here in a 3v1, and he dies. That's a 4-for-1 to the side of Potato.
Yeah, that's a big 4-for-1, and they're going to be able to pick up the dragon here, too. Fiora, I think, is going to get this top tower, or close to getting this top tower. Nope, it is going to go down, and they're going to have a fight here right after that.
I don't think she has enough HP. The ult lands. We have a visual bug there, but I think...
No, that was just a riposte. That wasn't a visual bug. That was just a great riposte there from the Facebreaker. But,
interesting.
He's going to be taken down. So that's going to be essentially a 5-for-1, couple of towers going up to the top lane. Mountain Dragon picked up for the side of Potato, and the gold lead now has been cut down to just a little over 3,000. So Potato putting up a good fight here.
So hopefully we'll be given a moment of breather here.
Whew.
3,000 gold lead. It's been cut a little bit. Thoughts about where this game is going?
Well, so interestingly, this Ezreal is starting to scale up. Ezreal does scale really well. Oh, we have another fight.
Ult gets popped by the side of Swain. Looks like they may try and disengage for just a moment, and the Lantern gets them out just fine, deciding to gentlemen's agree to just leave. But I don't know if Potato's going to let them. The hook lands. The Aatrox here does a ton of damage. Somehow,
Thresh just kills the Swain and gets out.
Thresh is still alive. This Aatrox does a ton of damage, but manages to just let Flowers escape. Another good hook landing.
Katachita is going to take him down on the Lilia. Blinded, little bit out of position, thought he was safer than he was, probably was, should have been a little bit safer than he was. And Thresher is just a menace. He's down, he's all the way behind the turret. They're going to try and kill this Fizz, this poor Fizz. Fizz is having a bad time this game. All right, so a little bit of a breather. Bot lane is going to go down. The bot lane tier 1 is going to go down to the side of NYU Talon. Sayarin is going to pressure in this mid lane. Set's going to look, though. Set's pretty strong. Bork completed plus the Bramble Vest. And here comes Swain as well. Great job on the ult there. Swain is, Aatrox is going to have to flash away from that one. That's a big summoner spell burn, and is going to be okay for now. But here's Flower Stand looking again. Drowsy going into the Swain under tower, but Sejuani's here to keep them off of it, and it's going to be no kills for now. That's maybe the first time I've been able to say that. No kills in that fight.
It's a bit of a relief, honestly.
Yeah, 22 to 19 at 19 minutes. It's been a bloody
game.
If
anyone has any of these players on their friends list, can you tell them to stop team fighting so we can talk about the game stages? We need a moment, dude.
Yeah, we've got two play-by-play announcers in this one. No color, because I just can't talk about anything. Another fight here in the jungle.
Oh, my God.
Windwall is going to keep most of that damage away. Turret is going to go down. That's a big tier 2 pickup. It looks like we're going to see maybe some resets on the side of Talon. I'm sure they have some gold to spend. Maybe production, or maybe you can take a quick look on your phone, see if we can find out if Aatrox has AP scalings, because I don't know, and he has a Magi Soul Stealer.
I have no idea.
I'm actually going to research it real quick. We're going to take a quick look on the internets about that, that Aatrox scaling. So, Tier 2 turrets already down in the top lane and the mid lane. Bot lane, Tier 1 down to the side of Talon. 5 turrets to 2. Gold lead back up to almost about 6,000 now. And Dragon, I believe, is spawning here in a minute or two. We'll see. Top lane. For some reason, top lane jungle is being prioritized, so we'll see what continues to happen here. Alright, you're going to start talking because I'm going to take a quick look at Aatrox scaling. So
well, in terms of items here, we have the Aatrox making his way towards picking up his second item, which I believe will be a Death Stance up in the top lane. We have two items completed, but no Mura mana just yet down in the bot lane for Yasuo. We have two items completed. Again, we'll be heading towards his third in the jungle. Just the first item for the side of Lilia. Over for the Ezreal, however, we have a nearly completed Mura mana as well as a Iceborne Gauntlet in the mid lane. The Fizz just has the first item in the way of the belt.
Hextech Proto Belt.
Proto Belt. Making his way towards what will assumedly be Azania's from top lane.
They're going to try to catch Fiora on the split, but what, unbeknownst to them, the rest of the team is just doing Baron, and there goes the Fiora. They are going to get the catch, but Talon's just going to finish off the Baron. So, Baron goes over to Talon. They do get one kill in return for Potato. I did find out that Aatrox has exactly 0 AP scalings, which means that this Magi's is literally just a flex. Interesting choice there. Set is on the wrong side.
Yeah, to be a bit of an offsides penalty here for the Set, and if he can pick the Lilia, that will be a nice consolation prize. He does, but then he falls down nonetheless. A 1-for-1 trade here.
Ah, that's 1-for-1, sure, but that is a Baron, another Baron buff taken off of the side of Talon. So, you know, not the worst 1-for-1 ever, and it means that they're not actually achieving anything with these Baron buffs in that top lane, taking the time to kill the Set, so not too bad. And they are going to get mid turret. That actually was a lot that happened there for just killing Set. That was actually surprisingly ended up being really good for Potato. And they're now in position for this Dragon. So,
what's unfortunate about having the Fiora die just before they picked up the Baron is that that's the player that you want.
You really want Baron on Fiora. That is. Also, Lilia's going to be late to this Dragon fight, which means that one of these teams has Smite. Flash away now from the, I believe the Swain was the flash there. Yep.
Well, it looks like they're feigning at a team fight here. They do manage to pick up the Dragon, and now they decide to go in. A really, really good Yasuo lands, but on the other side of the fight, we see Sejuani going down. Now down in the middle, it's just a Fizz. He manages to trade and kill back onto the Thresh, but does end up losing his life for it. Zyaran on the chase here and manages to pick up another, but that's two more kills going to the side of NYU Talon and two more kills onto the Fiora. They manages to end with a 4-for-1.
Yep, 4-for-1 here. It was a good look at the beginning, but I think just got a little bit out of position into that choke point. Yasuo with a huge ultimate there to really deal a ton of that damage and get onto the Ezreal. Like we've talked about, that Ezreal can dish out a ton of damage, but when Ezreal gets picked like that by the Yasuo, he's just going to die. So, mid lane inhib is going to be taken down by NYU Talon. They're going to
disengage.
I think
they were flirting with just ending the game.
I think they thought about it. They didn't quite have the death timers, though. Only 23, 24-ish minutes into the game at this point.
But an 8,000 gold lead.
8,000 gold lead. We've got farm leads in every single lane on the side of Talon. They've really just put the pressure on. is Fiora is starting to really get scary on that split push. As we can see, 4,000 gold difference for this Aatrox and this Fizz. That's the big one. 2,000 gold on the Ezreal.
Both lands onto the swing here for just a moment. He should go down without
He's
a lot
pop
to be
the
said about it.
Does have the Hourglass. Fizz is here and is Ezreal.
For a moment here, it looks like he was able to survive, but he ends up going down anyways. The return kills come in for Potato. That's a 2v1
here
in their
comes
favor.
Miles.
And it looks like Miles, you're trying to get a follow-up onto the Thresh. But for a moment there, it looks like the boots got popped.
Lilia's here too.
Manages to make his way out. The Lantern gets dropped, but Lilia decides against it. Wants to just go in anyways.
The
Drowsy lands onto two members. But you know what? This set is just too tanky. It doesn't end up mattering. And that ends up being a 3-for-1 to the side of Potato.
Yeah, Potato has some life here. Sayarin's caught out. This is a literal 1v5 at the moment. 1v4. There's going to be on the backline on Lilia. Lilia is going to go down. Miles on the backside. Let's see if Sayarin can do it. He's stunned up. He's going to look for the flash. Flashes over the wall. But Full Machine wants it. He's going to follow up. Here comes the Q, the chase. Slowed a little bit for the moment. Sayarin's going to try and disengage. Chain comes through. That's going to pull him towards the middle. And now Full Machine has to back off. Sayarin's still trapped in this jungle, but as we say it, Chrysalith is going to look for the tower. Is going to get one of the Nexus towers here. Is going to be rooted. Good riposte here, though. Fizz, is Fizz going to have the damage?
He's made his way into the base here, but he ends up just dying for it. He does end up getting one of the Nexus towers, but he blew his own lifetimer as well as a teleport.
His lifetimer, yes. And as a result of that, though, Sayarin is still trying. He's actually, I think, looking to get caught out here because of how much his team can achieve when he does. And he can't die right now, especially not with that ultimate off of cooldown, as it will be in a second. So, Nexus Tower going down.
This is a bit of sloppy play from the side of Talon. If they group here and push a lane, they can't leave.
But also, I'd like to give some credit to Potato holding it up. The recall does get finished, actually.
And Bob the Snake here found himself in a 1v1 with an Ezreal and no tower nearby, finishing them up with ease.
Yeah, cancel the back. And so he is going
to
sacrifice.
Thresh here looking for the hook, doesn't manage to land it.
Okay, quick reset on objectives. Baron and Dragon, I think, are both up in about 2 minutes each. As we have another fight, here comes the...
The suplex takes Yasuo into the team, but he has enough health here. Oh! Pops the ult of his own. It looks like he's going to go down anyways. Miles picks up the kill onto him, and we have a sleep onto the set. The set should just be taken down here with no trouble at all. They're trying to finish it up onto the Swain. Swain gets taken down, so Aaron is absolutely huge here. The ace gets picked up by Talon, and that should be the game.
Yep, just Ezreal here. It was an ace for just 3 seconds. Just Ezreal here left to defend a single Nexus Tower. And a big hook. That's going to be the Ezreal going down right now to the Lilia. There's the ace. And they are just going to push onto this Nexus and end the game right here. 27 minutes in. Gold leads at 10,000. 34 kills to 28 kills, over a kill a minute for both sides. That's going to be the win. That's going to be the 5-0 start to the NYU Student Championship for NYU Talon, and there goes the Nexus.
Unbelievable.
Really, you know what? At the end of the day, they were just, I think, mechanically too good for them. They, you know, trolled a little bit on the macro.
Yeah, I mean, it was sloppy, but I think that was intentional. I mean, their individual ability was... Really, I mean, it was really, really evident the distance between these two teams. Let's talk about player of the game. The one that immediately comes to mind for me is Sayarin. The Yasuo as well had quite a game. Can we look at the damage graph really fast?
Yeah, it would be great if we could actually see the damage graph. I'd be interested.
Interestingly enough, I actually would say that my second place, I actually don't want to say that I would extend it to the Yasuo. Bob the Snail ended up being the most fed. But I would say that second would be Thresh.
Yeah, I was just going to say, Flower Stan Jr. on the Thresh there had a lot of really great hooks, did a lot of setup, and just continually made it so that the Ezreal, who I think we talked about a little bit, really needed to be that scaling member, was just a little kind of unable to play the game, was predicting Ezreal ease, forcing him into positions he didn't want to be in. So I'm actually going to go ahead and I think just give the player of the game straight up to Thresh here.
Yeah, I would tend to agree. Flower Stain Jr.
he's in the Twitch chat saying
yeah,
Thresh.
Yeah,
that is the Thresh diff. 3-6-23, unbelievable.
It absolutely was. I mean, look, you have to give Sayarin all the credit in the world. Sayarin made a joke out of this mid lane matchup, but the thing is, it's kind of a joke to begin with. And when we started this cast, we said, "Hey, this is a bot lane that is favored for Potato."
Yeah.
And Flower Stan Jr. single-handedly proved us wrong.
Yeah, absolutely.
This game turned into a meme in the bottom lane. But I think that's about all we have to say. I guess my closing statement would be NYU talent. You guys are
they're the team beat right now. We'll keep an eye on them going forward into the next couple of weeks, see how they do. But NYU talent looking really strong. Like I said, perfect 5-0 start to the NYU student championship. I think that's going to be it. Thank you guys, everyone who's here, for joining us on the broadcast and being patient with our shenanigans.
We had a bit of an issue today. It was a bit scuffed to start off the day, but we ended it strong. Watching a really, really fun game between these two teams. Nonstop action. I need to go.
Yep. Follow us on Twitter. I think we might even have some Twitter assets that we can put on the screen. Also follow the Polygaming Network on Twitter. I think it's just at Polygaming Network. We'll be back right here at 3 p.m. Eastern next Saturday. Hope to see every one of you there and maybe some more. Bring your friends. It'll be a good time.
I've been Hotfish.
I'm Delta.
And we will see you next week. Have a good day.